This video will show you how to do a one-way ANOVA test using Excel. Here we have histamine concentration data obtained from 3 different fish samples. The null hypothesis for this example states that there is no significant difference among the histamine concentration of the 3 fish samples. The alternative hypothesis states that there is a significant difference among the histamine concentration of the 3 fish samples. To conduct a one-way ANOVA, first go to the Data tab located on the top panel in Excel. Then click on Data Analysis. From the list of statistical tests, select ANOVA Single Factor and click OK. Now you will be prompted to enter the data for the single factor ANOVA. To input the data, click on the square icon by the Input Range box. Proceed to drag your cursor over the entire data set, including the heading for each group of data. This set of data has been grouped vertically into columns, so here we will select the Columns option. If your data is grouped horizontally into rows instead, you can simply select the Rows option. Check the box that says Labels in First Row. Set the alpha level to 0.05. For output options, select Output Range and choose the area on the spreadsheet that you would like the ANOVA output to appear, and then select OK. The summary table shows that for this set of data, we are comparing between 3 groups of data with each group having 4 data points. In order to determine whether the null hypothesis should be accepted or rejected, the p-value of the ANOVA table is often looked at. If the p-value is less than 0.05, then the null hypothesis should be rejected, which is the case here. If the p-value is greater than 0.05, then the null hypothesis should be accepted. The f-value can also be compared to the f-critical value. When the f is greater than the f-critical, this supports the rejection of the null hypothesis. To confirm which of the samples are significantly different, we can use an LSD test. Thank you.